السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن لا أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر الله.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء وأطهر المرسلين، شفيع المذنبين وحبيب رب العالمين محمد، صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه الطيبين الطاهرين. إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأن محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. In the name of Allah, the compassionate, the most merciful, all praise is due to Allah. We bear witness that no one is worthy of worship but Allah, and we bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is indeed his final messenger. The best of speech is the book of Allah, and the best of guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst those who listen to the best of speech, the book of Allah, and follow his commands. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst those who find the best of ways to be the way of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and follow on his footsteps. Allahumma ya Rabbi, ameen. Allahumma ya Rabbi, inna nas'aluka fi mustahalli liqa'ina hadha an tahqina dima' al-abriya'i fi kulli makan. Allahumma ya Rabbi, khuss minhum ahla al-sham wa ahla misr ya Rabbi al-alameen. Allahumma ya Rabbi, ahqin dima'ahum. اللهم يا ربي ارحم ضعفهم، ارحم موتاهم، واشف مرضاهم، وفك اسراهم، وعاف مبتلاهم، واختم بالباقيات الصالحات اجالنا واجالهم يا رب العالمين. يا احباب رسول الله صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه، يقول ربنا جل وعلا: هو الذي ينزل على عبده ايات بينات ليخرجكم من الظلمات الى النور ان الله بكم لرؤوف رحيم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so beautifully reminds us that it is He who sends down upon His servant Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ayat in bayinat, signs that would clarify, messages that would clarify ليخرجكم من الظلمات إلى النور. So that through this guidance, he would take you out of darknesses into light. إن الله بكم لرؤوف رحيم. Indeed, Allah towards you is most compassionate, most merciful. سبحانه وتعالى. ويقول رسول الله صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه إن الله رفيق يحب الرفق في الأمر كله. He said that indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is compassionate. And indeed Allah loves to see compassion in everything that one does. Brothers and sisters, in a world that is so full of violence nowadays, that is so full of materialism, that is so full of exploitation and hate, we really have to remind one another, especially during this beautiful time of the month of Ramadan, that as believers, one cardinal trait of a believer is that a believer is compassionate. And we say this because in the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, تخلقوا بأخلاق الله. Derive your manners, the way that you are, from the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What does Allah say about himself? Now the attributes of Allah are befitting to his majesty at a level of perfection. But we human beings can relate to what it means to be compassionate, what it means to be generous, what it means to be sublime. So he said, take these attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and apply them upon yourself at a human level. تَخَلَّقُوا بِأَخْلَاقِ اللَّهِ. Let your manners come from the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if we're to read the Quran from one end to the other, we will find that the most repeated attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that Allah is compassionate. So much so that every time we recite the Quran, in all 113 chapters in the Quran, except one, it would tell us, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In the name of Allah, the compassionate, the most merciful. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us of his compassion throughout the Quran. And such, we as believers, we have to become the imbibing of these different attributes. And the best one to do this was Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because the Prophet, peace be upon him, would speak about himself and he would say, I am to you from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ana rahmatul muhda. Said, I am to you this gift of mercy presented to you by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And therefore, subhanAllah, all the teachings of the Prophet, peace be upon him, revolve around rahmah, wa'adl, wa maslaha. They revolve around compassion, they revolve around justice, and they revolve around benefit and usefulness. In fact, the entire deen of Allah is nothing but compassion, justice, wa maslaha, and imbibing benefit and bringing benefit to mankind. And like I said, subhanAllah, in our world today, we really need to have some compassion going on. Because we lack it. So much so that this CEO was once driving in the neighborhoods of Chicago. And he said that he came across a neighborhood and he slowed down because he was afraid that, you know, children might just be coming around. And he was driving, according to the story, his little Jaguar that was only 2 months old. You know, when you have that brand new car, it stays to be a brand new car for a long time. People get their license plates and they don't put the license plates on. Because they want everybody to think that the car is still brand new. So that was the state that it was in, and he was driving it and he was really happy showing it off. And then all of a sudden, out of nowhere, a brick flies through and bam, hits the door. And he's very upset, screeching brakes, put it on reverse, wheels spinning madly. He goes back to exactly where the brick comes out from and he gets out of his car and he's fuming with anger. And he finds the kid that threw the brick and he takes him and he pins him against the parked car. He said, why did you do this to my car? Do you know how much this is going to cost you? And the kid is crying. He said, mister, please, please just listen to me. What? He said, look. So that's my brother,
My brother is on a wheelchair and he fell and he hurt himself and he's too heavy for me to pick him up and nobody would stop for me and I had to do this because I needed somebody to stop. The man goes there and he helps the kid, puts him back on the wheelchair and he said, it was the longest walk back to my car. Because we've become so cruel that it took a kid to throw a brick at a car to get somebody's attention. And to his credit, that man said, I never fixed the dent on my car. Because I wanted it to be a reminder for me. Because subhanAllah, this idea of compassion, so important, and sometimes we look for it and sometimes we refuse to give it, even though we are fully capable of doing that. They say that compassion and kindness is an inner desire that makes us want to do good things even if we do not get anything in return. It is the joy of our life to do them. When we do good things from this inner desire, there is kindness in everything we think, we say, we want, and we do. But there is a problem with this definition. When they say that it is the desire that makes us want to do things even if we do not get anything in return, wallahi, anything they say you can give away. Anything you can give away and it can get lost, except compassion and kindness. You know why? Because it will always come back to us. Because it will always come back to us. So when we say that I am doing it and I'm not waiting for anything in return, that is not true. Because it will always come back to us. Compassion will always come back to us. In fact, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about His compassion and the fact that He has put compassion in our hearts. خَلَقَ لَكُم مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُم مَّوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً. Said Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knowing you, He's created mates for you. And He puts amongst you love and compassion so that you may find tranquility there. Subhanallah, they say that when we know that we are loved or we are in the presence of somebody who is compassionate and somebody who is kind and merciful, that is when we really feel sukoon. That is when we feel tranquility. And that is how the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam felt. Subhanallah, even when their behaviors did not warrant, according to us, compassion, but rather they warranted strict enforcement and being emphatic. Subhanallah, and the stories are many, and many times we have heard them. The man who came to prayers, and in prayers somebody sneezed. So he stepped out of the line and he looked at the man and said, Yarhamukallah, bless you. And in Salah, we know that nobody's supposed to talk. So people said, they started staring at me. And in Salah, people are staring at him and he's asking them, Salah, what? What did I do? What's wrong with you? And this is all happening in Salah. And as soon as Salah is over, he said, فَالْتَفَتَ إِلَيَّ النَّبِيُّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. He said, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم looked back. And he said, and he looked at me and he said, and the man said, فَوَاللَّهِ مَا نَهَرَنِي وَاللَّهِ مَا كَهَرَنِي. He said, by Allah, he did not yell at me. He said, by Allah, he did not scold me in front of people, but rather he said, إِنَّ هَذِهِ الصَّلَاةِ لَا يَحْسُنُ فِيهَا الْكَلَامِ. He said that this salah, he said that it is not fitting that we speak during salah. And that was the end of it. But here is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as in that definition, kindness is in everything that we say, we do, and anything that we think. And as a result, what happens is that subhanAllah, it becomes a second nature that everything that takes place just becomes compassionate. You know, these times, people usually speak about the Battle of Badr. And there was an incident in the Battle of Badr as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is making sure that the believers are ready and he's putting the line so that he would tell people what to expect in the battlefield and how we're going to fight this war. And there was a man by the name of Sawad who intentionally stepped out of the line. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Ya Sawad, irji'. Sawad, go back and line up with the rest of the people. Ya Sawad, irji'. Ya Sawad, irji'. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam pushed Sawad. And so, said Prophet of Allah, Ya Rasulullah, awja'tani. He said, Prophet of Allah, you hurt me, man. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, hit me back. Go ahead, hit me back. And the man said, but Prophet Allah, this is not fair. He said, because see, my tummy was exposed when you hit me, and you got your garment on your tummy, so that's not fair. So the Prophet ﷺ lifted his garment. He said, wait, fine, do it, hit me. And he said that Sawad got down on his knees and he kissed the Prophet ﷺ. So why is that? Because they knew that the Prophet ﷺ was nothing but a walking compassion, subhanAllah. And when one looks nowadays to what is happening in Syria, what is happening in Egypt, what is happening in all these places where, subhanAllah, there is so much violence in Iraq. This happens to be one of the deadliest weeks for the people of Iraq. Wow. But the sad part is, all of this is happening in the month of mercy, Shahr al-Rahim. And a good amount of it is happening in the name of Allah and in the name of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One cannot help but say, are you serious? Are you really serious? People who think that it is okay to go to a group of worshippers and shoot them while they are praying, thinking that such a behavior is pleasing to their creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You just say, are we really reading the same book? Are we following the same man, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Do you really know what you are doing? You're doing this in the name of the one who declared himself to be Ana Rahmatul Muhda. I am that gift of compassion sent to you, mankind, by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You do this in my name, thinking that you are following under the teachings of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the Prophet, peace be upon him, said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ رَفِيقٌ يُحِبُّ الرِّفْقَ فِي الْأَمْرِ كُلِّهِ وَمَا كَانَ الرِّفْقُ فِي شَيْءٍ إِلَّا زَانَهُ وَمَا نُزِعَ مِنْهُ إِلَّا شَانَهُ صَلُّوا عَلَى رَسُولِ اللَّهِ. Said that Allah is compassionate. And he loves compassion in everything that we do. And then the Prophet, peace be upon him, said that everything that is done with compassion, subhanAllah, no matter how small it is, he said that it adorns it, it makes it look very beautiful. And then he said, وَمَا نُزِعَ مِنْ شَيْءٍ إِلَّا شَأْنَهُ. And whenever anything that is done with no compassion, he said that no matter how good that thing is, it makes it ugly. You did the right thing, but you were very cruel when you did it. You did the right thing, but you were very cold when you did it. So what happens? He said that even though you're doing the right thing, but the attitude and the spirit that you did it with was not really helpful. So the recipients of it, they really did not see the goodness in it, simply because of the way that it was delivered. Brothers and sisters, subhanAllah, they say that intentional hunger really does impact the heart by making it softer. You know, when we are hungry, say that the whole idea is Allah does not really take anything from us being hungry. But the point is that contrary to what we think and what we do, you know, they have bumper stickers nowadays. It's a joke. But they say, be careful, driver is fasting. You know? Be careful, the driver is fasting, meaning that I'm not in my best behavior. I'm going to be easily irritated. Do not cut me off or you know what will come your way. So be careful, said driver is fasting. It's a joke, but that's how we think. Because now I'm hungry, I'm easily irritated, I'm easily provoked. Akhi, wallahi, that's not the point. But rather the point is that when we are like this, we are supposed to be harboring more compassion and more mercy into our hearts. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to do so, ya Rabbil Alameen. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على رسوله المصطفى وعلى من بآثاره اكتفى. Sometimes erroneously we think that compassion is unmanly. That if you are a man, especially we live in a culture that tells us that boys don't cry. And reality is that real men cry. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he had his grandchildren come in, and subhanAllah, you've got to remember the stature of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is the messenger of Allah. And when these grandchildren would come, and Hassan and Hussein, The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would make them sit on his lap, and he would be kissing them and playing with them. And he sallallahu alaihi wasallam would go down on his knees and hands, and they would ride on his back, and they would say, "Ya Jamal, Ya Jamal, you know, you are the camel." And they would ride the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and say, "Ni'ma al-jamal wa jamalukum." He said that indeed, fortunate is the camel that you are riding. He said that it's an honor for me to be your ride. So a Bedouin was not accustomed to this. And he was seeing this man that was supposed to be up there in authority. And he looked at the Prophet and said, "Ma hada?" He said, "What are you doing?" "Wallahi innani 10 min al-abna ma qabbaltu wahidan minhum qat." He said, "Allah has blessed me with 10 children and I have not kissed a single one of them." And sometimes you don't know whether to laugh at this statement or just say, "What are you thinking? You have 10 children and you have not kissed any of them." And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam looked at him and he said, "Wa ma af'alu laka in kanat ar-rahma qad nuzi'at min qalbik." He said that, "What am I supposed to do to you if mercy has been snatched out of your heart? What do I do to you?" Because simply they made the mistake that thinking that such acts happen to be unmanly, not knowing that tenderness and kindness are not signs of weakness and despair, but manifestation of strength and resolution. And that is what we are invited to do in this, not only in Ramadan, but that is how we are to be throughout. Please be kind to your families. One person put it so beautifully, he said that the only way that you know that your life is worth living, or the day that just passed was a day that was worth living, if you have extended an act of kindness to somebody else. Especially those who are around us. Ya akhwani, billahi alaykum. Sometimes, wallahi, we make the mistake that we are so kind to the outside world, but the world inside, the people who live with us, are the people who suffer most from our cruelty. Wallahi, I have people who call, brothers and sisters and children and parents, and they say, "You know that sweet husband of mine? You know that smiley wife of mine? You know that nice father of mine? Do you know this son of mine?" Say that you should only see them at home and see how it is that they are. Wallahi, this does not count. This is nothing but a show to the outside world. You can't be telling me that you are a nice person only outside, but the people who are closest to you, they don't see any of it. Wallahi, that is not acceptable. Wallahi, that is not acceptable. And if we think that this is what is going to make us good, wallahi, we are lying to ourselves. Wallahi, that is a lie. People who beat people who just are, come on, this is an unacceptable behavior. Not in Ramadan, not outside of Ramadan. So please, inshallah, let's develop this habit. The idea of, you know what, I'll be kind in my thoughts, in my words, and inshallah, this is going to show up in my actions. These are, inshallah, beginning tomorrow, the last 10 nights of Ramadan. And subhanallah, the time has passed by so unbelievably quickly. Unbelievable that today is actually the 18th of Ramadan. Can you imagine this? 18 days of Ramadan are gone, which means that only 12 days are left. But we are told that these last 10 nights of Ramadan are the most special and they are the most valuable. Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr. That we have sent down this Quran in this night of value, night of power. And this night of value, night of power, is anticipated to be in the last 10 nights of Ramadan. And say that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam kana idha dakhala al-ashr al-awakhir shadda al-mizan. Said that the Prophet, peace be upon him, when the last 10 nights of Ramadan would come, he said that he would roll up his sleeves, a sign that, you know what, this is when the real work starts. So inshallah, this is when the real work starts. You know, maybe we didn't do as well in the past 15-17 days, but inshallah, the last 10 nights is the time that we make up. So please, inshallah, let us all seize the opportunity now that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us to be witnesses during this month of Ramadan, that we do our utmost best. We do have a program for the last 10 nights of Ramadan. We pray Taraweeh and then we come back again for those of us who are able at 2:45.
And from 2:45 to 3:45, we will pray as much as we are able to. And then from 3:45 to about 4:45, we will have our sahur. And this is something that is open to all of the community. Of course, our brothers and sisters are welcome to join us. And inshallah, this will start from tomorrow, meaning Sunday early morning. So Sunday at 2:45 a.m., inshallah, we will be here. And as a reminder, this part of our neighborhood is a residential area. Please, if you plan to come, and we would love to see you, please be as respectful as possible to our neighbors. We cannot say that we are here gathered for a noble thing, but yet we are rude to our neighbors. That is part of practicing compassion. If somebody is sleeping, please let's not be the source of their disturbance. So please, inshallah, let's use this parking, let's use the businesses behind us, since they are not operating during this time, inshallah. Also tomorrow we do have, and Sunday we do have the community iftar. Please, if you would like to join us, purchase your ticket so that we are able to accommodate you in the best of ways. Please remember also to pay your zakat al-fitr. Please pay it as soon as you are able so that it can be delivered to the people who are in most need of it, inshallah. We do have a program, the Eid gift, the wish list. If you have taken a wish list card, please, we do need the gifts to be back here next Friday, August 3rd, so that we are able to deliver it before the day of Eid, inshallah. And also the Eid festival is happening August 17 and 18 in downtown Anaheim. See the flyers outside. Please keep Sister Fairuz, Sheikh Muhammad's wife, in your dua. Alhamdulillah, she is recovering. She is doing much better. And she still is in need of our prayers. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give her a speedy recovery. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give all the people who are not feeling well a speedy recovery. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless the souls of those who passed away. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us and our children and our families, ya Rabbil Alameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our fasting and our prayers. And make us amongst those who have been successful in this month of Ramadan. Allahumma ya Rabbi innaka afuwwun kareemun tuhibbul afwa fa'fu 'anna. Allahumma ya Rabbi farrij hammal mahmumin wa nafis karb al makrubin wa qdi ad-dayn 'an al madinin. Allahumma arham واشف مرضانا وفك أسرانا وعاف مبتلانا واختم بالباقيات الصالحات آجالنا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم يا رب ارحمك بالمستضعفين في كل مكان. يا رب ارحمك بالمستضعفين في كل مكان. اللهم يا رب ارحمك بالمستضعفين في كل مكان. يا رب ارحمك بالمستضعفين في كل مكان يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون.